This is the video and sound quality of the Samsung A80 using its main camera at about arm's length. This is the video and sound quality of the Samsung A80 at around 2 meters distance. This is the video and sound quality of the Samsung A80 at around 4 meters distance. This is the video and sound quality of the Samsung A80 at around arm's length shooting with the 1080p camera. As you can see, it's a very, very wide angle lens I'm using right now. This is the Samsung A80 at around 2 meters distance using the wide angle lens. And this is the Samsung A80 shooting at 1080p, and you only get the super wide lens, as you can see, which is by the way, the widest lens I've seen on the phone that I've tested. And you will only get this when shooting at 1080p.
Okay, so this is the Samsung A80, a test for stabilisation, contrast and dynamic range. How well do you think it makes up for those dark colors even in direct sunlight? Now I'm moving into a tunnel, so it will become dark, and I'll see how it lights up my face, if it will do anything to do something about it. I'm filming, of course, with the selfie cam. Not that much selfie cam, because it of course has this rotating camera, which makes it ideal for blogging in a very high resolution. I'm using the highest resolution possible, that's 4K for this instance. And this is without stabilization on, and you'll be able to record in 4K, but you can see how much the picture moves around in these situations. So you want to have stabilization on, hence meaning you'll come down to 1080p. You'll see how it copes now. I'm into the tunnel. Pops the colors really good, I think. Also very much light to my face still. Of course, it should be able to produce a very good film and contrast in these situations. So we'll see about this. So now, how does the darks look? How does the darks go out even in this direct sunlight? I think we're off to a pretty good start. By the way, I'm using this auto stabilization because this camera has a terrible tendency to like really, really, really jump the picture. So I put it on just in case. I hope it makes up for some of those horrible stabilization issues it has in many uses.
Okay, so this is the Samsung A80. Shooting at 4K resolution, everything is as is. I've not even put on for this shot, not even put on this auto stabilization, because I think I'm holding this camera with two hands. It really, really ought to have a minimum amount of stabilization, which is, well, the stabilization is exactly the problem with this phone. So how do you think it copes? Is this a bit of a dodgy situation, because we always have the sun right there opposing this shot, but I'm always standing at the same spot. This is the evening shot on the Samsung A80, and I only got 3 light sources in the room. I got that one, I got that one, and I got this one, which is of course always the tricky one, because it has to try to compensate whenever I move my face in front of the camera, and I do not. And the better light it gives to my face, typically the better the camera and software is. So this one does an excellent job. I'm recording right now in the selfie cam 4K. So that's not much more to say about it, but it's no stabilization. So that's what you get. This is Brian, your tech friend, and you may want to subscribe for best phones to use when vlogging.